Anyhow, I've been asked to address you in English for the next 10 minutes. 2 minutes is almost over, and I've got 8 minutes left. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَالْأَوَّلُ وَالْآخِرُ وَالْظَاهِرُ وَالْبَاطِنُ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. He is the one who's the first, he is the one who's the last, he is the one who's omnipresent, he is the one who's unseen or invisible, and he is the one who knows everything. That's the translation of the verse of the Quran Kareem. As we all know, this is a Milad-e Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we are discussing the main issue and the history of the 1400 years of Milad al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Has the loudspeaker been having a problem with that? I don't have any complaint with it. I know this is a sensitive system. If you stay too close to it, that's it's going to cut off. So you have to keep it away if you're keeping your bass on and highly. So that's what the problem is. When you're coming too close and speak too high, it cuts off. So isko bichare ko exam dene ke bajaye mere khayal mein apne aap ko set kar lena chahiye. Anyhow, here is the verse of the Quran that which means Huwal Awwal. In the beginning, sa huwa. Huwa, if you understand as in English grammatically, it's a personal noun. In Arabic language, in grammar, the sciences will explain to you that whenever in Quran in Arabic you have to mention or Quran mention the Arabic personal nouns like huwa, then they have to have a name before that. So you have to mention, just like in English you say that Zayd came in, for example, Zayd is the person's name, or John came in, use your own language names as well. So then he said. So first you have to mention somebody, then you said he said. So wherever in Arabic as well, that you have, when you're going to use a personal noun, you have to use a name before that. Otherwise it doesn't qualify anybody. So how will you understand this, that who is qualified by these verses? Let me remind you and tell you that in the Quran Kareem, the number of times will be mentioned like this. So what is the method to understand? Method of understanding is that whenever there will be a personal noun Zamir in the beginning, and that's how they translate as a Zamir Shan, the high class, the specialty of someone. So who's that special? So they've been given us a method of understanding that out of three personality, one personality will be mentioned from there. In the three zatom, we see one of them is. Number one is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number three, Quran Kareem. When there will be no name mentioned at all, and then something will just start like this. Out of these three, we have to mention one. So in that sense, it means that huwal awwalu, wo awwal hai. Sabse pehle Allah ki zaat ko lete hain. Yehi takriban har mufassir yehi baat lega. Allah sabse awwal. Huwal akhir, Allah sabse akhir. Kyun? Allah was the first when there was nothing. Allah was there, and then Allah will be at last as well, because nothing, everything will be turned into nothing, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be still exist. Wo zahir ho, is baar ek guftu hai ki Allah zahir to nahi. Sare kehte Allah zahir hai, kahan hai ji? Aur aksar ummat ke log jo hai, majority of them, they believe that Allah is invisible and Allah cannot be seen. Jaise ki gaal mein Quran Pak ki ayat agar main galti ka karu to isra farma diye wa yudriku al-absar wa la tudriku al-absar, aise hi he, and normally they translate that he can see the eyes, eyes cannot see him. Actually, say, uska sahi mana ye nahi hai. Idrak ka mana do teen tarah ke mana se ki isse zyada bhi ho sakte hain. Teen mane jo mere zehen mein wo hote hain. Ek uska mana hota hai ki dekhna, as this Allah can see the eyes, eyes cannot see him. So dusra mana tha atkal pachhu karna, just guess what Allah, ye mana ban hi nahi sakta. Allah can guess about the eyes, eyes cannot guess about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yahan guess word bhi nahi banega. It's not going to be a guess word. So yahan kya mana banega? Idrak ka mana tha gherna, to cover something. Yes, when we see each other, I can see your face. Now if I turn down, I can see your back as well. You can see my face. If I turn down, you can see my back alone. So in that sense, what will happen, that we can see and cover each other. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not possible to cover that if you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Subhanallah.
Unhon mein se jamaate ahle sunnat, their our mazhab is Allah is visible in dunya as well. How? Not just like we see each other, as he is. Yes, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in this dunya, he went for ascension night in Miraj and he seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi, also Imam Ahmad Hanbal as well, they're both in narration has been given, they seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 99 times. And then he said, Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi said that, even I see 100th time, then I will ask question to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Ya Allah, how will you forgive this your creation when they're committing so many sins?
And then Allah, it happened that he's in the end of time, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was questioned by Sayyidina Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah, and reply was given as well. There is a long dua, which is praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One who does that 3 times in the morning, 3 in the evening, number of my students, they give them copy as well. If you look for one of them, probably I can provide you one and all. So whoever does that 3 times in the morning, 3 in the evening, I will forgive him in the day of judgment. So by all means, improve. But what I'm proving from this, Allah is visible. Aajkal ke Shia aur Wahhabi aur sare kare kare ji, ye Imam ul Azam ji kehte hain Allah ko maine dekha hai. Allah dekhne ke kabil nahi. To agar dekhne ke kabil nahi hai, if not visible, to zahir kahan hai?
Subhanallah.
Kyun janab main marat to say this? Where is zahir? Ab zahir ka maana kya hai? What is zahir? Allah is zahir from his power. The creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. Oh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala known through the Anbiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who arsala rasulahu bil huda wa dinil haq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not that you can see and recognize him. Allah to interpret himself, to show himself, he is the one who sent a rasul. So when you see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, man ra'alika dhra'al haq, who seen me, seen the truth.
Subhanallah.
So Allah ta'ala apni kudrat se dekha jata, warna that Allah is not visible. Who al batin, who batin bhi hai. Taang to mera, two minute baki. So I can go on that as well, but let me tell you that as a one side of it, this death is qualifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Shah Abdul Haq Sahib Maudisi Delhi rahmatullah in Madaraj an-Nubuwwah, in the right in the beginning he says that ye Allah ke liye ijazan sabit hai ek lafz ya ye mujazan sabit ho sakta hai do wajah ka ijazan ho. What does that mean? Ijaz kehte hain moajze ko. Moajza that when you deceive your mind does not accept. Something happened that your mind totally refused that cannot be happened. Something like that called mojza. Kya matlab? When there's nothing exists, koi banane wala hai nahi, khud ka khud aise mojza ho gaya, wo Allah ki zaat hai. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by himself. Lekin iske alawa mujazan. Mujazan kaise mana hoga? There is, whenever there is a awwal, there will be a sani. Ek hoga, dusra bhi hona chahiye. Allah ke koi aur Allah hai ji? No. Allah is only one. To jab sani nahi hai, ya Allah akhir, dusra akhir aur bhi Allah ho, wo bhi nahi hai. To ab kya maan hoga ki Allah koi aur nahi hai, Allah wo Allah awwala jiska koi sani nahi. Allah is the one who doesn't have the second. Allah is the one who, one, the first one who doesn't have the last one. You understand that? Ye mujazan maana hai. Asal main to huzur ki bargah mein pesh karna chah raha tha. Asal main ye sari ayat huzur ke liye.
Subhanallah.
In fact, sir Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, huwa al-awwal. Wo awwal hai kisme takhleeq e bari taala ka awwal ma khalaq Allah ul nur.
Wow.
Very first thing Allah subhanahu wa taala created is my nur. Then he translated himself as well. Awwal kaun hai? Sir wa awwalu man aamana billahi. Awwal kaun hai jo ke Allah ke sath iman laaye? Wa bi dhalik umirtu. Aise hi main hukm diya gaya hu. That's how I been commanded. And wa awwalu ana wal muslimin, o main pehla iman lane wala. Why? Bin Allah subhanahu wa taala brought everything in image and as a soul, and as alastu bi rabbikum, ki main tumhara rab nahi hu, am I not your lord? And then when anybody said that at that time, qalu bala, yes you are our lord, that was it. Number one was Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Isliye bhi huzur awwal hai, huwa al awwalu wal akhir wa zahir wal batin wa huwa bi kulli shay'in alim. Baatein sab bahut karne wali hain, ama alaina illal falah.
Subhanallah.